far as a recording, do you remember?
Probably within the context of doing our Neverly Brothers Band, we did some demos for that.
Right.
So that would be it. But really, these recordings, not actually that one, when I did my first CD, George played a few things on that.
On Armory Square.
On Armory Square. And I actually, he inspired a song, too, that I wrote about his breakup. So he was inadvertently on that.
And I got to play it again, relive it all again.
Jerry got asked to contribute a song to a Greg Spencer Christmas compilation record. We went in there and cut it with the Nevs, and Gary knew that I had been studying New Orleans piano styles. The Shuffling Hungarians had only been together for like maybe a year, and so I was sort of getting my arrangement chops together a little bit, but not really. And we went into Rondarolas and we cut this song, and when we were listening to the playback, I was hearing all this stuff. I was hearing horns, I was hearing background vocals, and sort of like an Alan Toussaint-ish sort of vibe. I arranged a horn chart with Paul Serra, and then I asked Paul Serra, geez, do you know any gospel singers that we could get to do? And he says, yeah, I know three of them. And this was Angie, Jackie, and Gail, the original George Ouellettes. I had never met them before, and of course, so we booked the session, and two of them don't show up. So now all the pressure's on, and I'm down to one singer. But we lay the tracks down anyway, and we stack the vocals, and Angie just did an amazing job, and the horn players did an amazing job, and I saw the future. I heard the future. I said, this is what I want my records to sort of sound like. So Sandman was really the prototypical Shuffling Hungarians.
And that was really a good collaboration point where we first came together.
Yeah,
Angie,
I guess so.
Washington, man. Check it out, man.
Santa Man, Gary Frenay and George Rossi, both in the studio tonight. The show coming up on Saturday the 26th, Auburn Public Theater. Get your tickets. They're going fast. It's not a real big place. It's a great place to hear music.
It seats less than 200 people.
And there's going to be a lot of people up on stage, including the Hungarian horns.
More band than people. You all know this by now. More band than people.
Everyone's going to get a tambourine and a kazoo.
Exactly.
We'll all join in.